Hello, beautiful souls. I am Awaken Soul, and today we're going to be reviewing XRP. It's been a while, so thank you for being here and giving me the opportunity to walk you through my process, how I see the charts, how I chart. It's one of a kind, let me tell you. I don't do a lot of voice TAs because I like to vibe. I like to play my music and chart. But here we are on the monthly chart, and just off the bat, remember, no expectations, no emotions, clear everything off. I don't want anything in your chart, just the candles. That's all you need to start your TA. So just off the bat, XRP is already telling me a story. If you follow me and know how I trade, I work a lot with the market structure and the Forex master pattern that holds contraction faces and trend faces. And if you want to learn a little bit more, please join me. This is my Twitter. Join my space. I am awakensoul_369. I have a free Discord where I live there pretty much. I'm there 24/7 posting. And I do have a educational course where I actually teach you technical analysis. Okay, so off the bat, we have two contraction phases. One contraction phase, two contraction phase. So this is telling me that this is our monthly contraction phase, so we're going to be focusing on this range. Okay. Give me 1 second. I do share everything with my subscribers on Discord. They get all the images that I, as I chart anything that I do. They're the first ones to get it. So let me go ahead and send this image to them so they are aware that I am about to chart XRP. Thank you. I hope you're having a beautiful day. Okay. So off the bat, we know there's two contraction phases. Second thing I want to start off with is always my 1226 EMAs. That tells me the story if we're in a bullish or bearish trend. And how do I determine that? I determine that by just looking at the wicks at price action, right? Price action above 1226 EMA, that's a bullish trend. Price action under 1226 EMA, that's a bearish trend. Bullish trend, bearish trend. So on the monthly, we are on a bearish trend, right? Because the 12 is under the 26. So just an observation. Okay, let's pull the Fib channel. And this is just to set critical trend lines. I just like to pull it like from lows to highs and just see what kind of story is telling me, to see if I need to like highlight any critical trend lines, any support resistance that I could see. So off the bat here, I'm going to go ahead and highlight this. And how do I know what trend lines to highlight? It takes time, right? One touch, two touch, showing me, you know, confluence of resistance. So that gives me that resistance trend line. This one touch and no touch, but this white trend line made sense to me too. I like to focus on price action. So not so much what's going on over here, but what's going on here. And another observation that I'm making here is this white trend line, right? Anything else? No, not right now. So based on my Fib channels, those are the key trend lines that I got out. So knowing that this is a contraction phase, and now drawing those trend lines, now I can see that this is like a channel, right? We have a nice channel, ascending channel. Okay. So now that I have my key monthly trend lines based on my Fib channel, I'm going to start my TA. How I always start is looking at the previous candle wick and setting my range, because I am a day trader. So as a trader, you want to focus on your ranges. So this is your monthly range. So everything tells you a story. So what is the story telling us already? The story is telling us that price action is under our monthly resistance because price action is under. So it's a bearish trend. 1226 EMAs are down, so that's bearish. Okay, so now that I have my range, I'm going to move on. It's a parallel channel. Hold on. Let me draw the channel again. So I like the channel. When I find a nice channel like this, the reason I like it is because it has this like 50% like horizontal line. It's not horizontal right now, but you know what I mean. This little dotted line. It's and this could be used as our kind of support. And it's support because price action is above. So, right? Just align it nice and tight. And I do color coordinate everything. I use the chakra colors. I start off on my monthly, so my monthly color is red. So, get it together with my colors, guys, because a lot of my charting doesn't provide my voice. But I'll always stick to my colors, so if you understand my colors, you're good to go. So there's my monthly chart. It looks cute. I like it. Right? Really bearish at the moment. I'm gonna go ahead and send it over. I'm gonna go to my weekly. On my weekly. So on my weekly, I'm gonna concentrate on this zone here, not so much here, but just this. What is this zone doing? What do you see? What can you observe? Patterns more than anything. Every contraction phase will come with a pattern. So I'm always looking for any type of pattern that I could see, that I could visualize. So in our, just like we talked about the monthly being bearish. It's important to make an observation that the weekly is a bullish trend. Even though price action is under the 26, technically it's still in a bullish trend. Why? Because the 12 is above the 26. So now we're gonna go ahead and look at the previous candle, just like we did the monthly, and then label our monthly or weekly range. And that's my weekly range here. And what is this telling us? That price action is under our weekly range. So it's giving us more confidence that we are in a bearish trend. Okay. And it is a learning YouTube. So take notes, relax. The charts are not going anywhere. You got to put in the work to understand it, right? I'm not here to tell you or to guess where the thing where charts are going, where price action is going, because nobody could guess. I'm here to teach you how to fish for yourself. Okay, so now that I have my range, let's draw some trend lines. And trend lines could be a little bit difficult in the beginning. So I love this higher high, lower low indicator that I truly recommend everybody. If I would give you one indicator to use, it would be this one. I rotate the period. I usually like 30, 15, and then I use 3, 6, or 9. But 30 is really key. So I'm gonna set it in 30. And I want more highs and lows here just to, so that's not gonna work for me. So I'm gonna go for a 15. And again, I'm looking to connect trend lines. So right here, perfect. So on my weekly, this is going to be some sort of support here. And weeklies are orange. Right, and this. Perfect. So we have like this wedge going on. So right here, I want to start providing some targets. So I did not give you monthly targets, so let's go back and give you those monthly targets. So because again, one contraction phase, I forgot to do my monthly trend lines, just one touch, two touches right there. Right? And if you know my strategy, you know my the way I take choose my targets. So right now I'm looking if XRP breaks this monthly support, we're coming to 17 cents, guys, 17 cents. And that's what I've been waiting for. And I do think we're going to hit 17 cents, to be honest with you. And looking at this flag, I mean, we could even come down really low, 2.05. I mean, I'm not saying it will happen, but it could, and it would still be part of this contraction phase. Okay, this channel here coming, price action coming down all the way to 0.05 is technically part of this contraction phase. I'm not saying it won't, but it's definitely a possibility. So this is my bearish target. And another thing with trading, just no expectation, no emotions mean that if you're gonna set a bearish target, I expect you to set a bullish target too. Okay, just because this looks bearish and, you know, price action is under the 1226, it's under monthly resistance, doesn't mean we don't provide a bullish target, because anything could happen tomorrow, something, you know, the news, everything's perfectly fine and XRP could go to the moon, right? So one touch, two touch, you already know. And my monthly bullish target would be 1.33. Okay, let me go ahead and submit that to my subscribers. Super cute chart, and I hope you don't lose me. I hope you're kind of seeing what I'm teaching here. Back to my weekly, right? So on my weekly, that was my monthly. Where's my weekly trend lines? Okay, this is my weekly trend lines, the orange ones. So one touch, two touch, if price action would break up. Right here, same as monthly. And if price action were to break down, I guess we could use this high. 0.31 cents. Okay. Right, and as you can see, we're getting closer and closer to the range, right? We start off monthly, weekly, and now we're gonna go to the daily. And as we move in closer, the targets will condense and get closer, and it'll give us a better view of where the next move is headed. As everything is just price action, a mechanical structure. So let's go to the daily, Okay, so on the daily for XRP, as you can see, XRP is super, super wicky. So what I like to do, and not only XRP, but with a lot of charts, I like to pull the line chart. The line chart just gives me better confidence on where to set my trend lines. So for my daily, I know this is my monthly support. Wow, it's literally like right in the edge here. So this is gonna be my one touch, two touches, and dailies are yellow. I actually don't like that. Nope, one touch, two touches. And yes, guys, this is how it takes a while to do TA. You can't just jump in the charts and take a trade. You need to understand the flow, understand where the possibilities are. What is the next move? So one touch, two touches. I don't even know that. So weird. And I'm sorry, but I gotta think and talk. And usually I'm really good at thinking, but not talking at the same time. But I'm doing my best. Something. let's think, guys. Let's think, right? This is what it takes. It takes you understanding the flow, you understanding, okay, this could be a channel to the downside, right? But we're here, this is monthly, this is daily. What is our daily range? The daily range is the same as the weekly, so I'm not gonna mark it. But if I had to mark it, same process as the weekly, we are under the daily resistance here. Okay, I don't like this trend line. Okay, so this is actually pretty when it comes to contraction faces. So this is a great example of a contraction face. This section here, this is its own contraction face. So sometimes, just like you saw right now, sometimes I get a little bit overwhelmed of what's going on and I forget. Okay, just focus on price action. So it's a good way for you to remember, like, okay, just pause. If you have a situation like me right now that I'm like, okay, what's going on? I'm not sure. Just reset and remind yourself, okay, what are the basics? The basics are setting your range at the previous candle, right? And setting trend lines around your price action. And again, focusing on your contraction phase. What pattern, what do you see within your contraction phase? So let's just focus on this area. Forget the noise. Let's cover everything but this area. So on my daily here, I'm gonna throw a POC up. Okay, so this is our contraction on the daily. This is our POC. Price action is under POC. So like I've always said, every contraction phase will bring a pattern. So let's try to find a pattern within here. I like to turn on again my higher high, lower lows, and this time I'm going to use a 3. And this is going to show me and guide me on setting key trend lines. One touch, two touches. One touch, this wrong one. So this is just going to be my resistance for the daily. I'm not going to put support because we have the monthly support here. So obviously if we break here, we could come all the way down, or we could wick all the way down like we did here and recover, right? So let's keep moving in to our 4 hours. On our, oops, I forgot to send it to my Discord. Give me a second. We're gonna do this. I'm gonna go to my 4 hours. So in the 4 hours, we can see nice contraction phase here. You see this sideways movement, trend down, sideways movement. So we're in a range right now on the 4 hours. I wouldn't be taking any trades within this range. It's really choppy. And that just comes with the experience of me knowing that, okay, well, it's within a range. That's where I'm gonna, it looks like a H to be honest with you. So I'm gonna, cute little H here, just off the bat. And 4 hours are green. Color coordination is key. And I'm gonna set my, again, another nice resistance trend line here. And where's gonna be my support, my 4 hour support. I'm gonna do one touch. So it looks like we just broke 4 hour support here. Right, and I used the, what is this, daily, because it's yellow. That's why I color coordinate everything. I use the daily as confluence to choose this trend line to come to this. Okay. So with that being said, we're breaking 4 hour support. Oh. I'm going to use this wick, one touch, two touches here. And I'm going to give you a target for the 4 hour. Perfect. Pretty low. It's coming down. It's definitely coming down. I mean, and it's not my personal opinion. It's what the short charts are telling me right now. So that's my setup right now, especially once we break this monthly support. She's gone. Absolutely. Could she come down here and then just bounce up? Absolutely. No questions asked. That could definitely be a possibility, and it could just drop as easily as that. So that's your range. I hope you learned more than anything, right? I'm not trying to give calls or anything here. I'm trying to teach you how I visualize the charts and how I see the charts. Thank you so much for stopping by. I love you guys, and remember to do everything with love.